Hey guys, it's Navjot Singh Jadeja here again, and in today's lecture for data mining, we're going to talk on KDD process. If you're a student of data mining, you know how important KDD process is. It's the heart of the data mining subject, right? So what are we talking and what is KDD? So quick introduction, it is knowledge discovery from the data, or some books refer it as knowledge discovery from the databases. So what are we trying to actually extract? We are extracting interesting patterns or whatever you call as a knowledge from a very large amount of data. This large amount of data comes from multiple sources. That is what we are discussing in the lecture of data warehouse also. But what should be the qualities, what should be the characteristics of the data which we are trying to extract? So it should be non-trivial, it should be implicit, it should be previously unknown, so it should be the new pattern, right? And it should be something which is potentially useful. But now the question arises, so if you are actually doing knowledge mining, or if you are seeking knowledge from the data, how is it data mining? So guys, we will discuss that furthermore in the lecture also and in the further videos also, so stay tuned. So let us understand what are the different names in which KDD is known as, or data mining, or even knowledge mining is known as. So one name, as we saw, is knowledge discovery in databases. It is also known as knowledge extraction. If you are in certain companies or the older companies are still referring as pattern analysis, some people refer it as information harvesting, and the latest and the buzzword is business intelligence, right? So data mining is actually everywhere. If you understand from the simple Google search, or your Facebook recommending your school friends which you have not met for 10 years, how is it happening? That is data mining, guys. So let us understand what the KDD process is all about, what happens in the data mining. So this is a typical diagram which is have taken the reference from the Hannon Campbell book, which is considered as in the Bible for data mining. That is what I used in my college days. And let's break this diagram into simple steps for you to understand. So before you go further into this, this is an analogy which I'm going to share with you right now, is one which I use in my classes when I teach. And if you remember this, I'm sure you can actually remember writing knowledge discovery in databases or KDD process in the examination very easily. Relate this data mining process with the cooking of the fish analogy. So you might think, how are we connecting? Let's do it. So what are we supposed to do if we want to actually cook the fish? So we need to have the fish. So that fish is nothing but which data you have in here. So it comes from different databases, or the collective databases which is known as data warehouse. Now going back here, once you have the data which is your fish, what do we need to do? We need to clean it. So in this step, we remove the noise, we remove the inconsistency, and there are different techniques related to that. So what is that? Again, going by the analogy, we have to clean the fish, right? Then what do? We actually do data integration. So what is data integration in terms of data mining? Here we are multiplying different sources or different multiple sources into a combined form, right? Remember in the analogy that fish needs to start with lot of masalas, right? Next up, what do? Data selection. So going by the fish example, we select which is a good part of the fish, we remove the thorns, we remove the unwanted material, and in the data mining, we keep the data relevant to the analysis task. So if we are actually going by the analysis which requires the number of patients which are infected through communal transmission in COVID-19, I will not be focusing on their financial backgrounds. Why? Because that is not relevant. So here I select relevant data. Then I perform transformation. Going by the analogy, what do? We actually cut, chop, and put it into the ingredients, right? So same way, in terms of data transformation in KDD, data is transformed into a form which is more suitable for the tools or the system where we are going to supply the data. Next up is data mining, which is our cooking. So basically, we apply different data mining techniques such as supervised learning, unsupervised learning, etc. And that would actually extract some data patterns. Now, the fish is ready to eat, but what do? Should we serve it directly to the guest? No, we evaluate, we taste. Just like your mother's in the kitchen, we will take a sponge and taste it. That is what we do in here. We do the pattern evaluation. We check if the patterns are helpful. We check if the patterns are appropriate or not. And similarly, once that is done, we garnish the plate. We garnish the, you know, the fish in a way where guests like it. Same way, knowledge presentation is the step where we serve it in a way where the business leaders or the people who are supposed to take decision understand that in a way which is simpler. So the form which the business taker, decision makers understand, not only the scientists. So this is the whole KDD process. Again, a quick overview before we finish, that we start with data cleaning, we end with knowledge presentation. So from cleaning, from there we go into integration, then selection, transformation, then mining, evaluation, and presentation. And remember the fish example, guys. If you like our effort, if you like our trick, please like, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.